I just wanted to drop this video because I have been playing around and trying to understand the new edit image feature from Dreamstudio with Stable Diffusion 1.5. So far, I think it's pretty cool. So let's just check it out. Okay, so let's just get straight into it. If you haven't tried this before, you can go to beta.dreamstudio.ai and you get a lot of prompts for free, I think. So, but what I wanted to look at today is there are some new features here. Of course, we have the Stable Diffusion 1.5. That looks very good so far. But today I noticed this initial image feature. So if we click on here, we can upload our own images and use those as a starting point for editing and creating other images. So let's do a few examples and I can show you what I have figured out so far. So this is very easy to use. You just start by uploading an image. Let's start with this image that I actually created today on my live stream, if you want to see that. So now that we have our image here, just crank this scale up to 10. And what I found out is if I just type in steampunk style and I have the image strength set to 50, then this is going to change the, it's going to keep the composition and the base image, but it's going to try to change the style. So now it added kind of its own steampunk style. But what I also found out, if I change the image strength to, let's say, 75%, then it's going to keep more of the original image, this one. We're going to do some small style changes. But if you turn this image strength all the way down, say, 25%, then I suspect, or I found out, you get like a whole random kind of image. So let's see. Yeah. Let's try some different styles and see. Okay, let's start by typing in add a carbon fiber look to the helmet. So hopefully this changes like the look of the helmet. That was quite cool. Okay, let's try a Viking style. Okay. I get it. Let's try cyberpunk. Oh yeah. That was cool. That was awesome. Let's try something completely different. So add sharp edges to the helmet and laser lights, aka digital painting cinematic octane render. I'm also gonna blow up the steps, so that should give us some more details. Let's start with 100. Yeah, that was cool. Could we even go more? What if we go 15? And let's try 15-100. Yeah, that works. Okay, crank it all the way up. Go 20 and 150. So this is max. I think that looks good. I'm gonna save this. Okay, so I also have to try this selfie and see, like, if I go oil painting. Yeah, I can see that. That was cool. Okay, let's try Family Guy. That was great. I can't really say it looks like me, but I love it. So I have this image I created earlier, but I really wanted it to look realistic. So I'm gonna go ultra realistic, ultra detailed, octane render, cinematic 8K. Wow. Wow, that was good. I didn't expect that. Okay, so here I have a different variant, almost the same as the last one, but let's try to run the same prompt again. Oh, yes. Oh, that's cool. This gave me some ideas. Okay, so this is another one. Let's try this same prompt. Oh, yes. This is cool. Okay, so now let's do this with one of my favorite images so far from Stable. Wow, that's insane. This is such a cool feature. Okay, so I hope this gave you a bit of an insight of this new Stable Diffusion feature. So I think it was pretty cool and I think you should check it out. If you want to watch more Midjourney or Stable Diffusion videos, you can check out this one. Anyway, thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.